Video games is a real problem in today's society. It is a form of escapism for men who can't handle their real life. It sets up for anxiety, depression, and degenerate lifestyles. There is no reason to use lots of time on video games when you can develop skills, solve problems, do social interaction, and discover fantastic places in the real world like it was in a video game. Your real life is like a video game. You are a character, you are yourself. The way you try different things, interact with the world, develop skills, and develop yourself works in a very similar way compared to a video game. Watch this video if you want to get an awakening from your gaming life and to envision and pursue your real life goals. You should find developing yourself as a real world character fulfilling, and you don't need any video game for that. Give this video a like to help the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe to me to stay updated on more self-improvement content and fitness on my channel. Some of my main topics are masculinity, mindset and self-development, and muscle building, strength, health and aesthetics. I really want to develop an engaged audience who want to improve themselves. It's sad to say, but video games, like they work in today's society, is really a shame, setting people up for instant gratification, less presence in the world, and less inspiration and drive for real world problems. I have made a video about this topic, and my conclusion was that video games is an escape from a traumatized and uninspiring life, making you disregard your real world. I have been a video game addict before. I have done the transformation in my mind. I try to make all video game addicts do. It's about recognizing your real life as more important than a game and making development there like it was an addiction. Video games can be compared to drug abuse, and using too much time on them will make you a degenerate loser. At least I was one at the age of 12 to 14. The reason you should stop playing video games, or at least play less video games, you won't stop it overnight. It actually needs time. But it's because the lifestyle it facilitates sets up for less presence in the real world, and it destroys your brain and physical shape. You destroy your brain's dopamine system by too much instant gratification, your oxytocin system because of too little real world social contact, your physical health because of a sedentary lifestyle, and cognitive functions because of a mindless lifestyle. The antisocial, sedentary and mindless lifestyle gaming sets up for will destroy testosterone and masculinity and set up for earlier aging. The effect you get from decreasing stress levels is just a temporary crutch for you, and you should find other ways to lower stress in real life. There is no reason to use lots of hours on video games when you can do mindful and relaxing activities like walking in the forest, meditating, reciprocating with friends, and relaxing in the sunlight. Gaming has actually taken over for masculine and important real world activities like chopping wood, fishing, farming and hunting deer. Therefore, you should embrace your real life goals, do testosterone inducing activities and find effective ways to relax. I think an important part of the process of escaping a video game addiction is to envision your real life as a video game. You are a character, you are yourself. You build up a character like it was in Skyrim, or in World of Warcraft, or Runescape. But in this video, I want to use Skyrim as a reference frame. I think the steps for overcoming a video game addiction are: first, you need to recognize your life outside the game is more important than the game itself. Second, you need to envision problem solving and skill acquisition in real life like it was in a video game. And three, you need to start setting goals in real life and learn how to improve. And fourth and last, you need to keep yourself motivated on the real life grind through fun and interest, urgency, challenge, and the perception of something new. This sets up for understanding how to grow and grind in the real world, and you should really try to escape your video game addiction and find inspiration and motivation to achieve big things in real life. You develop skills in real life like it was in a game. You solve problems in real life like it was in a game. Of course, it is more difficult, but the abilities you can develop in your real life have quite a similar distribution and setup aspects like the skill tree in Skyrim. You have different types of intelligence in the way you understand the world. You have many different brain parts and body parts. You need to find a way to grow. You have different types of skills. There are so many things you can do to challenge yourself. The age we live in now should be the age in the world history with the least possibility to get nihilistic and depressed. There are social skills, theoretical skills, practical abilities for work life, and sport or motoric skills. A huge variety of abilities you can improve to becoming better in real life. Your skills also determine your value in real life. All skills can be used for a job you can earn money with. Graphic design can set you up for a graphic design job. If you get good at making figures at Canva, you have the abilities you need for working at a graphic design job. If you have service skills, basically serving other people, you can work at a grocery store or at a kindergarten, delivering important value in today's society. If you have got sales skills, you have the abilities to become an effective marketer, negotiator, and business driver. You have the ability to communicate, create value, and delivering important products for a market. If you have analytical skills, you have very good abilities for project management, any business development, any research job, and anything needing creative thinking ability. In the same way, you do different activities to improve skills, both in real life and video games. In the real life, you talk with people, work at your projects, read stuff, use your brain to think, and move your body to develop skills. In Skyrim, you do quests, talk with people in the game, fight with enemies in the game, raid dungeons, and explore the world in order to get XP and develop skills. It's the same, but in real life, you are yourself you have created throughout your life, not an orc or an elf you have generated through the game. Everything you do in Skyrim is an improvement process for your character. So should everything you do in real life be. You should manage your time to maximize productivity, fulfillment, mental clarity, and your shape. In addition, every improvement process in companies, businesses, or in academic sectors are problem solving and skill acquisition. Any marketing or analytical mission in a company can be compared to a quest in a video game, except that the latter one is easier. Both for your life, at any workplace you work at, or any video game you play, it's a process needing implementation, analytics, and networking. By that, you should understand that video games is less productive than your real life development or any development at your workplace. When you develop a real life skills, there are many aspects in the ability, and there are many parts of a process you need to think about. However, I will argue that the main principles of progression and skill development in real life and in video games are very similar. It's the principle of progressive overload and experience. In real life, you become better at doing things by making them more difficult and doing more in general. In video games, you become better at getting XP. In Skyrim, you improve your two-handed skills as a warrior by using large melee weapons wielded with two hands in combat and making it more difficult. You get perks, making you do more damage, making you more agile and effective in combat, making you do more critical and bleeding damage, and making your enemies more prone to damage in combat. In boxing, like a real life skill, you improve your boxing skills by getting experience with boxing training and making it more difficult. This includes specialized training of basic moves, footwork, agility, oxygen intake, reciprocation with others, defensive moves, and awareness work and sparring. You can envision your skill profile as a combat athlete in a fully similar way compared to a skills tree in a video game. In phone sales, you become better and achieve better communication, sales, and conversation skills by getting experience from a phone sales job. You improve your eagerness for approach, charisma, presentation skills, social intelligence, empathy for others, linguistics, talking speed, and understanding of value. Developing sales skills in real life can be looked as freaking similar to developing persuasion and talking skills in Skyrim, except that the latter one is way easier. You should have a big drive and motivation to improve skills in real life and have a growth mindset for your personal development. I have many skills I want to develop. I think the biggest way I can develop myself as a person is by communication and social skills and my presence. I have many ways I can develop my presentation skills, my linguistics, my empathy for others, my emotional control and understanding, and my conversational awareness. I want to develop a way where I can sound more inspirational and charismatic. I think talking with girls on a night out is a very good way to develop those kinds of skills. It's really a test for how you can develop small talk into big talk in a short time frame. And it's kind of a test for emotional triggering ability. Even my eye contact in real life interaction can be improved. And I really want to talk with hand gestures when I make YouTube videos. At the moment, my hand-to-brain connection while speaking English is quite bad, so I really need to improve it. I want to improve my analytical skills. I look at myself as a very analytical person, and understanding is a very big part of my personality. I want to apply analytics better to practical understanding and real life, and I think a good way to develop it is to describe something to somebody else. About sports and motor control, I want to develop better skills in boxing, basketball and football. I want to develop an even better understanding of gym programming, biomechanics and physiology and apply those topics better when I talk with other people and deliver value and help other people as a fitness coach. I think a very good way to help yourself is helping others. Furthermore, I want to develop skills for how to keep my mind calm, more easily find a positive state of mind, and improve my mental clarity. I want to improve my sexual market value and my dating skills in general. All the abilities I have mentioned can be set in a system of a real life skill tree, like it was in Skyrim. The variety of skills in real life and how you develop one ability is very similar to the system of skills and perks in Skyrim. And you have to remember, every improvement process is an analytical feedback loop with yourself. You need to think, try, execute, and evaluate. For every interaction, you need to observe, analyze, evaluate, and reflect. Therefore, achieving any progress is more difficult in real life than in video games. Everything in video games is set up linear. You know the process. You have very clear rules for how to achieve progression. And everything is more predictable. Therefore, I think problem solving in real life is way more fulfilling. As it sets up for delayed gratification, there is way more depth and understanding to achieving goals in real life. So by this, I want to promote your own life growth as a video game. You are in charge of everything you do and what happens to you in your life. You don't need any video games to achieve fulfillment. You can truly achieve your fulfillment by your real life growth. Your skill acquisition, progressive overload and development in real life is very similar to in a video game. And you should be on a grind to improve yourself as much as you can. I really appreciate if you can like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you all for watching and see you in the next video.